Antioxidants. Introduction and classification types. My name is Dr. Alam Zeb. I am a professor at the Department of Biochemistry, University of Malacca. Today we are going to answer some question. For example, what is an antioxidant and what are the requirements for compounds to be an antioxidant? What are the different classification or classes of antioxidants? Introduction. An antioxidant is a chemical compound that inhibits or stops or control oxidation of a substrate. It may be an organic or inorganic in nature. So it may be both from biological and non-biological species. The substrate is known as an oxidizable substrate, and it may be anything. Our definition of antioxidant varied with its application. It depends on where this concept lies, but the overall general concept of the antioxidant or the mechanism is similar. We can define an antioxidant as any substance present at low concentration compared with those of an oxidizable substrate significantly delays or prevent oxidation of that substrate. In food science, antioxidant has been redefined as those substances present in relatively low amount in foods which inhibit or delay or control oxidation of food components, consequently prevented spoilage and extended shelf life of food. Inhibition of oxidation resulted in the delaying of oxidation. You can see here the different type of lipids or the unsaturated fatty acid present in cereals, seafood, dairy, meats, edible oil, etc. After their oxidation, their quality is reduced. So when we delay this oxidation, we enhance the shelf life. What are the requirements of a compound to be an antioxidant? Those substances are usually required in a small amount, are those which give a proton atom very easily and which neutralizes a free radical and which form a stabilized radical, and also it is soluble in biological or defined media. Usually this should be non-toxic to human. Types of antioxidant. Antioxidant types or classes can be categorized into different classes. The first type of classification is known as primary and secondary antioxidant. The second type of classification of antioxidant is natural and synthetic antioxidant. And the third one is enzymatic and non-enzymatic antioxidant. So these are the three known different type of classification system present in for antioxidant. The first one is primary and secondary antioxidant. First, we need to know what is a primary antioxidant. Primary antioxidant are those which neutralize free radicals either by donating a proton atom or hydrogen atom simply using HAT, or by a single electron transfer or ACT mechanism. These antioxidants are very efficient and normally required in very limited amount to neutralize a large number of free radicals. You can see here a single primary radical, a primary antioxidant, react with the millions of free radicals to form a stable radical. The high catalytic properties of these antioxidants are one main reason for their diversity in nature. These antioxidants are easily regenerated, so this is the another property. Examples are phenolic antioxidant. Phenolic compounds, antioxidants are present in plant. For plant food, you can see here the example are 4-hydroxybenzoic acid, 2-hydroxy-4-methylacetophenone, 3-4-5-trihydroxybenzoic acid, and 3-4-dihydroxybenzoic acid. Now we need to know what are the secondary antioxidants. These are those compounds which are characterized by the mechanism of neutralization of prooxidant catalyst. So they usually quench one free radical and are thus easily exhausted. Here in this picture you can see a secondary antioxidant react with one free radical, and it is then a secondary antioxidant. So we have the examples which include chelators, prooxidant, metal ions, that is iron and copper, such as ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid, EDTA, and citric acid are the examples. The second type or classification of antioxidant is called natural and synthetic antioxidant. This type of classification is based upon origin. So first we need to know what are natural antioxidants. Natural antioxidants are those which are obtained or present in the biological system. That is, they are originated or synthesized in nature. So here you can see a lot of food products, whether from animals or plant sources, they contain all these natural antioxidants. For example, berries, different type of berries, the honey, and the fish, the oils, etc. A wide range of antioxidants is included in naturally antioxidant class. For example, This class contains phenolic compound, carotenoids, tocopherols, tocotrienols, and some organic substances. Synthetic antioxidants. These are those antioxidants which are synthesized in the laboratory or industry for enhanced food protection. So they may be obtained from the natural, but they are modified in the lab. For example, butylated hydroxytoluene, butylated hydroxy anisole, tertiary butyl hydroquinone, propyl galate, or the examples of those synthetic antioxidants. And here you can see their structure: butylated hydroxytoluene, BHA, BHT, TBHQ, PG, propyl galate, and then 1,3-trihydroxybenzene, and also the gallic acid. Here you can see that gallic acid is actually a synthetic, is a natural antioxidant, but normally these are similar to, these compounds are similar to the natural one. The third type of classification of antioxidant is called enzymatic and non-enzymatic antioxidants. Antioxidants may be either enzymes or non-enzymes in nature. The enzymatic antioxidants have some characteristics. For example, mostly they are protein in nature. These enzymatic antioxidants are further classified into primary enzymes and secondary enzymes. So the primary enzymes are those which include superoxide dismutase, which we abbreviate as a SOD catalase, and glutathione peroxidase. The secondary enzymes with antioxidant properties are glutathione reductase and glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase. So this classification is based upon the direct prevention of direct antioxidant and non-antioxidant. Now the non-enzymatic antioxidants, the rest of the compounds are all included in this class, which include vitamins, carotenoid, phenolic compound, minerals, sulfur-containing organic compound, etc. So this is somehow this base is a big class.